does this happen? That's the purpose of this vlog. How does this happen? The cable guy was here yesterday to get new cable and new internet. And you got cable, internet, phones, whatever the bullshit she gets. She handles all the bills. It's another blog I have to do. Handles all the bills. And the bills are so high for the cable, the internet, on the kids' phones. I don't know what they do. I don't understand gigabytes and YouTube and video, whatever gigabytes you have to have on your phones. All I do is my phone rings. I go, hello, hello, hello. I don't know how the phone works. I push the button. Hello, hello, hello. I don't go to YouTube. I don't put movies on. I don't put music. I put nothing. I just say, hello, that's it, my cell phone, my iPhone, whatever the hell it is. It's not even my iPhone. My kids keep getting new iPhones. They give me their old iPhones. You think I know what the hell's going on? If I had that shoe from Get Smart, I could talk on the telephone on the shoe. That's the easiest way to talk. What happened? Phones. I used to pick up the phone. I dial a number. I say, hello, and I talk to people. Now, it's so fun. With applications, I'm technically inept. I always have been technically inept. I'm a genius marketer. I'm a genius, talented, funny, great guy that should be the billionaire that I will be. But even back in 1980, 82, 83, when I started a company called Guess That Song with my good friend Eric Feld, which will be another blog, before there was 976 numbers or anything, and I was in the subway, and I saw an ad in the subway, get lottery results, 976 lottery, whatever it was, for 10 cents. This was before Datelines, before anything with 900 numbers or anything. It was just to get lottery results, get weather report, 976 number, 50 cents. At that time, I thought, I'm going to do something called Guess That Song, where you have to guess a song. And my good friend Eric Feld and I put up $7,000, and I put answering machines in my basement. Where everyone else had IVR systems and cables, I put three answering machines. Then I cut deals with radio stations. I cut deals with West Coast Video. It was a video store, movies for videos. And they put flyers in there. And the phones are ringing off the hook at 50 cents a call. But for three answering machines, which was stupid, but I didn't know anything else about technology, about IVR systems. And who knows how many calls I was missing out on. I was on cable TV. I was saying, hey, you want to guess that song? I was on the radio. I was a terrific promoter, as I am now. But technology could have made me the billionaire then. Because the guys with the IVR systems, whatever, the proper systems you should have had, I could have been a millionaire. I'm always ahead of my time, like Thomas Edison. Think of me as Thomas Edison. So when I came to Canada, there was no 900 numbers, no 976 numbers. I was telling all my friends, this is the wild, wild west. This is how to get started here. But again, I didn't know about IVR systems and cables and stuff. So the guy that got started knew about this. And they made a fortune. And when I came and wanted to do it, I had to work for them. Because I said, I want to put dating on television. I want to put girls and guys on TV. And I didn't have the 900 numbers, but they had the machines, they had the cables, they had the bell lines, everything I don't know. So I partnered up with them. They gave me $10,000 to produce a show. And I produce a show and make me partners in the company. But I never saw a dime because they make so much money. Why do they have to pay David Bronstein? I just got screwed up another deal that I'm going to tell you about another blog I'm going to do. But I'm an easy mark. I wear my heart on my sleeve. I shake your hand. I honor the deal. Nobody else honors the deal. That's besides the point. But then my good friend Andrew Wells, and I deviated from this blog, said, stop making money for everybody else. I'm going to put up $40,000. He put up his house for $40,000. We're going to go in business together. And Andrew handled the IVR system, the cable lines and the telephone lines, the technology of it that I'm so inept about. And I did what I did. I'm a promoter. I produced the television shows. I booked the airtime. I got the girls. I said, go to the phone. What are you looking at me for? And guys were calling the lines and spending $40,000 a month on their phone bills, $20,000 a month on their phone bills. We were spending $250,000 a month on airtime. Andrew and I were buying television time to run my dating shows. I was running 150 times a week. But we all have our own expertise and talent. So when I just do what I know how to do, and my business partners do what they do, we make a lot of money together. We build the empire. But don't ask me to change a tire because I don't know how to do that. And don't ask me to put the light bulb in. I don't know how to do that either. And don't say, well, you have to learn how to do that. I don't want to learn how to do that. I just want to know what I know. God gave me a gift of comedy, of talent, of producing. That's why we have gifts. And if you use your gifts to make money, you could be a billionaire. Now, what the hell was the point of this blog? Oh, here's the point of this blog. So Andrea got in touch with Rogers years ago and bundled everything all together. I don't know what the hell's going on. The bills are so high. And I didn't even pick up emails on my phone. I didn't want to work when I'm outside the computer. When I'm outside the office, the computer, the studio, I don't want to work. When I'm at the movies, at the restaurant, at shopping, I don't want to have to pick up emails on my phone. I don't want to be controlled like that. But many, many, many months ago, I said, all right, put my emails on the phone because I had a lot going on. So the kids put my emails on my phone. That's all I do is pick up emails. My cell phone bill should be $30 a month, $35, maybe $40 tops. The kids' phones, I don't know what it is, but whatever the hell it is, the bills are astronomical. The phone bill with Andrea and the cable and the end. I said, I can't, this is insane. I said, I have a company. I'm going to get my own account with my company and I'm going to just handle my company and it's a free for all. You guys, you handle whatever. It's all up. It's all in your head now. I'm not putting up with this bullshit, whatever the hell you're billing stuff on because it all comes back to me. So I called Rogers and they came in to give me cable for my television and internet. But the cable that we used to have, whatever it is different than the cable now. Here's how convoluted and crazy this is. I called Rogers. I said, I just want basic cable. I don't watch movies. I don't watch movies on demand. I don't watch the digital channels. Whatever the hell's going on in the cable world, I don't watch that stuff. You know what I watch? I watch X Factor. I watch Glee. I watch The Simpsons. Family Guy. Stuff that's on regular television. I don't have time to watch. I got DVDs. The kids bought me DVDs. Breaking Bad and Curb Your Enthusiasm. I have DVDs for the past 20 years I haven't watched yet. I'm in a one-man show, but that's another blog altogether. So the guy, so I said, great, cable's going to be $30 a month or $35 a month for David Bronte's new cable. I'm going to give you this high-speed internet because these computers are so slow here. They must have mice in the cage spinning around to give us the internet. It's so slow. The newest internet, wherever it's going to be. I said, I just want it on this computer. That's all I want. I have a computer here and a computer in the other room. He said, do you have a laptop? I said, no, just everyone else. All my kids have a laptop except me. What do I need a laptop? What am I going to take? Am I slip around the laptop? What am I going to do with it? Just give me the cable, the internet here, because the internet we used to have was in the living room. I don't know why it was in the living room. And I go in the bedroom here to go on the computer. I said, just put it by the computer. That's all I want, the internet there. And I already had the boxes, whatever boxes I needed. I had the internet box, the digital box, whatever boxes are in the house. I don't know what the hell's going on. They said, fine, we're going to come out Friday. We're going to come out between 8 and 11 or 11 and 2, something. Well, 8 and 11... I got to take Andrew to work. I got to take Jared and Lauren to work. I'm going to miss him. I said 11 to 2. Then I find out Jared's graduating on Friday in high school. Andrew's not going to work. Everyone's going to be home. We're not going to be home between 11 and 2. What am I going to do? I'm not going to call him back. You know what it's like to have the cable guy come to the house. So I said, I'll take a chance. Hopefully he'll come here before 1:30. Of course he didn't. So I had to call him again. Now they're coming Saturday, meaning yesterday. And they're coming between 2 and 5. I said, fine. I'm going to be here between 2 and 5. And Jared says, can you take me? I got to do a photo shoot for this webisode. I got to do it at 1 o'clock. I said, I can't take you. I got to stay here for the cable guy. Jim Carrey. I got to stay here for the cable guy. Fine. Now I'm waiting for the cable. Every 2 minutes, the phone's ringing. I think it's the cable guy because they have to call you to tell you they're coming. I don't know why. I said, I'm going to be here. They got to keep calling you. So I did a blog about Jared's graduation. And if you watch it, you see me, the phone ringing, me running out of the blog to answer the phone because I think it's the cable guy. And somebody calling for Denise. Why are they calling my house for Denise? I have no Denise. There is no Denise here. I don't know who the hell Denise is. I don't know anything about Denise. I don't want to know anything about Denise. And they're calling me about Denise. Who the hell is Denise? I know who the nephew is. The nephew I know. Denise? Don't know. So I finish the blog, whatever it is, but I'm waiting for the cable. Finally, the cable guy comes at 10 of 3, or as you say, 2:50 p.m. or 10:23. I'm from Philadelphia. I say 10 of 3. 2:50 p.m. Great. Now, Andrew says, we're going to the movies today. We're going to the movies with Mark and Joyce and... we're going to go see That Perfect Pitch. It was another blog. It was a great movie we should do. And I'm picking you up at the movie starts 4:45. I said, well, the cable guy's here at 10 of 3. So how long is it going to be here? Till 10 of 4 an hour? How long does it take to put in two cables and the internet box? I got everything. How long does it take? It took 2 hours. That's maybe over 2 hours. I don't even know. I wasn't even here. When Andy came to pick me up at 4:30, the guy was still here. From 10 of 3 to 10 of 4 to 4:30, Jared came back from his photo shoot and said, Jared, you got to stay here. For the cable guy, because I don't know what the hell he's doing. Now, he was a very nice guy, but I couldn't understand him. He had an accent. I couldn't understand what the hell he was saying. And I was telling him, I just want cable, and he's telling me I'm going to put a cable in his accent, whatever it was, and you only have TV channels 3 to 27 or something. And I said, but I want channel 28, where I watch The Simpsons, and 31. No, you have to have the box, you have the digital box, and you get PVR and the demand. And I said, I don't want the, whatever, I don't have digital. I'm going to get HD. I said, I don't have an HD television. Jared has an HD television. I don't have an HD television. I don't know the first thing about it. I just want to watch television. That's all I want to watch. And I just want the channels, ABC, NBC, CBS. Are there any other channels besides ABC, CBS, NBC? That's, I heard Fox is a new channel. That's all I want. Well, you got to have the digital box. I said, just give me the digital. I got to get out of here. It's a joke from the Castles I keep talking about. Give me the valise and I'll get out. David Jack knows that joke, but it's another joke. I keep deviating. I said, just give me the cable. I got to have television here. Give me whatever cables you're doing, because I unhooked everything. So I had no cable, because you got to put it in again, whatever the hell he was doing. I said, so give me the cable to my company name. That's all I want. And give me the whatever you're telling me. Well, I have to call the office now because I'm giving you, you wanted basic. Now I'm giving you digital. Now I'm giving you high speed. Now I'm giving, I said, call whatever the office. I said, whatever you have to call. I'm going to the movies. And the clock keeps ticking, ticking, ticking. I got the dog barking the whole time. The dog's in my lap now. I'm like a James Bond villain with the cat in the lap. I got the dog in my lap now. And the dog is barking, barking, barking while I'm trying to hear what the guy says with an accent. And I can't understand him. And the dog, you know how loud this dog barks? Constant barking. He won't leave the guy alone. I have to go outside and leave the guy in the house by himself. Probably packed up the whole house and moved out already. I'm walking outside with the dog the whole time because I can't. The guy can't work with the dog barking, and I don't know what the guy's telling me. And all I want is the cable connected so I can watch television and the internet. So he does whatever he does. I don't know what the hell he did. Because he's still connecting, and I said, listen, I got to go to the movies. So then he calls the head office, hello, Mr. Bronson, we want to make sure that you know what you're getting. You're getting the cable package with the digital and the high speed and the PPI. I said, yes, this call's being recorded, so you know, for quality assurance. It's a wonderful. I said, I got to go to the movies. I just give me the internet, the TV, whatever the hell you give me. I don't know what they're talking about. I just want regular channels, ABC, CBS, NBC, a new channel called Fox, I heard. That's all I want. I leave. I said, Jared, will you talk to the cable guy? He's going to tell you how to work the machines. Because I have TiVo. And the guy said to me, nobody has TiVo anymore. TiVo's old. Nobody has it. I said, I have it. I've been using it. No, you can't use it because when I connect the TiVo, you're not going to be able to watch all the channels you want. I said, what do you mean? He said, you're not going to be able to set it for this time and this channel and this channel. I said, I do that now. I'm able to do that all the time. Now, no, not when I give you this box. When I give you this box. Okay, maybe you can if I give you this box. That's what he said. All right, now maybe you will be able to. You won't be able to. You couldn't. You shouldn't. I said, I just want to do what I used to. I want to watch television through the TiVo. I want to be able to record stuff with the TiVo. Nobody has TiVo. Now they have the Rogers PVR. I said, I don't know how to work the Rogers PVR. I have the TiVo. I just want everything the same. Just put it in my company name. That's all I want you to do. Because it was an Andrew's name and the house name. And they can't change it for whatever reason. So I'm getting it so I can take control of the situation. So the bills won't be astronomically high, whatever it is. And I'll take care of everything. So he's telling me I can't use the TiVo. And then I can use the TiVo, but I can't use it. I can't tape Fox at 8 o'clock and then change it to ABC to tape The Good Wife at 9 o'clock and then change it to tape Bob Wives at 9, the NBC. He said, I can't do it. I said, I do it now. Why can't I? I said, isn't technology supposed to move forward, not move backward? I said, Jared, you're going to have to talk. I don't know what he's saying. The dog's barking. I said, you're going to have to find out what the hell's going on here. I don't understand what he's talking about. And make sure everything works like it's supposed to work. Then I leave and I go to the movies. And this is the purpose of this blog. That in my world, it's either the way it's supposed to be or the way it is. Unfortunately, it never is the way it's supposed to be. It's always the way it is. And it's a struggle and it's a fight all the time to get it the way it's supposed to be. I don't know why. Those are the cards I've been dealt. And I constantly fight to get it to be the way it's supposed to be. Now, the nut to my world, they think that, I don't know, they think the way that the way it is, that's the way it's supposed to be. And it's causing me fighting and arguing and yelling and screaming to explain to them why, if you're associated to me, this is the way it's supposed to be, but they just don't get it. So I leave to go to the movies yesterday. And it should be that easy. The cable guy comes, he connects cable, he connects the internet. And I push the buttons, everything works like it's supposed to be. And then I go, everything's real easy. That's not the way it is. Here's what happens. I go to the movies to see Pitch Perfect. It was a great movie. We go out to dinner with the friends. Great! Well, Jared has a party last night because it's a party for his graduation. That's another blog I did already. He graduated. It's been in university since September. It's October. But he just graduated high school. I don't know what the hell's going on. No, he didn't flunk out. They had graduation ceremonies in October. All the kids had to come in from college. Already in college. What the hell do they care? They have to come in to get the diploma, but they're already in university. The way it's supposed to be, the way it is. So all the kids came in, all his high school graduating class came in from college. All the kids couldn't. They're in Minnesota, they're in Wyoming, they're in England, they're in France, they're on the moon. They couldn't come in for their graduation. They're already in college. A lot of kids came in, they had a party Saturday night. So after the movie, Jared's calling Andrea at 8 o'clock, 8:30. You got to pick up my girlfriend, you got to pick me up at the in-laws, you got to take me to the party. So after the movies, it wasn't as easy as I come home. Jared's here. He explains to me, this is how you work the internet. This is how you work the remote. This is now with the new TiVo. This is where you got to push the buttons because you have two antennas now. You got to move the antenna to over here, the antenna number one, antenna number two. Can't tell me that. I go from the dinner, about 9:30, pick up Jared's girlfriend, who we love and adore very much, and then to the in-laws because Jared's keeping company with the in-laws. Now we pick up Jared. Then we pick up his friend Grossman. Then Andrew makes Rice Krispie cakes, whatever she's making. And now it's about 10 o'clock at night. I haven't been home yet. And I would drive Jared to the party at 10:30 at night. Then Andrea has to go to the store to get Motrin because she has a headache. And then I get home at 10:45 at night. Great. Can't watch television. Can't watch the internet. Pushing all the buttons. Can't figure out what the hell's going on. Can't figure it out. I'm on Jared's computer now. Couldn't get on the internet on Jared's computer. Oh, I finally figured out which is another blog. I'm pushing on all these buttons. I'm kicking, I'm banging, I'm flipping lights off and on. I don't know what the hell's going on. You're not connected. You're not connected. You're not connected. I got boxes and wires all over the house. I'm not connected. The television, I'm pushing the buttons. Nothing. I keep hearing a repeat. This is video on demand. Movies on demand. Here's the movie. They keep repeating like coming attractions and movies. That's the only channel I get on my television. Coming attractions. Coming up now. Coming up next. Come. It's the only thing I get on television. Can't figure out. I got a movie that's antenna 1, antenna 2. But no one's here to explain it to me. I had to go to the movies with Andrew. The cable guy's here for over 2 hours. I don't know why. Jared's here. He supposedly explained it to Jared, but Jared's at a party. And I can't talk to Jared because at the party at 10:30 and a quarter of 11. So 11 o'clock at night, can't watch television, can't watch Saturday Night Live, can't do nothing. So I said, well, I might as well go to sleep. What am I going to do? Read a book? I read my Las Vegas books. So I go to sleep. Jared comes home, maybe 3 o'clock in the morning. Because I woke up and I saw it from his party. Partying, ball, whatever the hell he's doing. But now, he goes to sleep. I get up. I'm up every morning at 7 o'clock, 7:30. That's my biological clock. I try to stay in bed a little bit. I go to sleep at night. I'm dreaming about Madonna. I don't know why. I was dreaming about, I think, Paul McCartney, too. I don't know why. And I get up at 9 o'clock. Great. I get up at 9 o'clock in the morning. My neighbor, my Jewish neighbor, knocking the door, wants me to come in the sukkahs. And it's sukkahs this week. And shake the etrog and the whatever it is. I was thrilled. So I get up. And now Jared's still in bed. I want Jared to show me how to work the television, how to work the internet. But he's still sleeping. So I get up, I go in the sukkahs, I come back, Jared says he has to go out now. I said, wait a minute, you got to show me how to work the internet, how to work the tele. You got to show me how to, I'll do it when I come back. Now it's 11 o'clock, I said, I'm going to go get a bagel. I still don't know how to work the television. I can't figure it out. So then he goes out, whatever the hell he's doing. I go out to get a bagel, it's 12:30, it's quarter one. What time is it now? It's 1:22 now, I think. Yeah, 1:22. Andrea calls me about 1 o'clock. Jared's at my in-laws, he's throwing up, from the party, he got sick, he's taking a nap. I said, Andrea, it's 1 o'clock in the afternoon Sunday. I still can't figure out how to work the television. Well, you're going to have to figure it out. He can't come now, you want to watch television here? I said, I don't want to watch television there. I said, I just want him to show me how to work the television. Only two people know how to work the television and the internet in my house. The cable guy from Rogers and Jared. The two of them are in cahoots. The two of them figured it out. They said, listen, don't tell David. That's what's going on right now. Because they're the only two people that figured it out. The cable guy tells Jared, then they both run away, and I'm stuck here like a schmuck with a dog on my lap doing blogs telling you, why does this happen to me? How does this happen to me? It's 1:30 in the afternoon now, and I can't figure out how to work the television. I can't figure out how to work the internet or this computer, the internet. I got it yesterday, and then it went away. And now after I do this blog and put it on, it's going to go away again because you got to push this button. It's at the airport. It has some... The D-Link, there's so many technical issues with this internet here. Why isn't he connects to the internet? I go on the internet, that's it. I can't even go on the internet on my phone. I said to Jared, I need you to connect my phone. You have to go to the settings so I can get the internet in the house on my phone. I can't. He said, I'm going to do that. Then they run away. He's probably with the Roger Cable guy right now. They're saying, ha, 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 ha. Look, David doesn't know how to walk the internet on television. This is the purpose of this blog. How does this happen to me? Why can't things be like they're supposed to happen? If they were like supposed to happen, I wouldn't be doing blogs. Why can't they be, here's the cable, here's the internet, you push this button, you work, great! Why can't it be like that? Why does it have to be like this, where everything is always a fight, and everything is always a trudge uphill, and everything's always constant meteors thrown at me, and distractions, and constant! This is my world. And I wouldn't change it for anything else in the world. Now go to davestvempire.wordpress.com. I need eBay guys. I need video guys. I have rebuilt the empire. And there's so many talented kids on daveswebstars.wordpress.com that are making a fortune. High school, college dropouts. I tell Jared and Lauren all the time, they don't get it. But if you go to daveswebstars.wordpress.com, that nobody goes to anyway, you'll see these high school dropouts making 60 grand a month, 100,000 a month. A month! Blogging, uploading videos, selling merchandise, and I'm going to do the same thing. I tell my kids all the time. Jesus, I got so much gas. I can drive to Pittsburgh and Atlantic City. I tell my kids all the time, you want to be successful? Do what successful people do. Go to davestvempire.wordpress.com. If you know how to upload videos to YouTube, if you know how to create quick landing pages, if you know how to put stuff on eBay, I do business with Shark Tank, Dragon's Den type TV product suppliers. I'm in the infomercial business. I can produce infomercials. But I need web guys to market my stuff online. I need them to put them on eBay. I need sales guys to get them in stores and retail. So you'll see a lot of business models on davestvempire.wordpress.com. And all the business models where everybody can do except David Bronstein. Only David Bronstein can produce infomercials and buy the airtime. I can figure that part out. Anything else online, can't figure it out. So if you're a social networking expert, you're on YouTube and Funny Junk and E-Bombs World and Facebook and Twitter, you figured that part out, Go to Dave's TV Empire.wordpress.com. Let's make a lot of cash together. And I'm talking about cash today because I'm in the today cash business. Dave's TV Empire.wordpress.com. And then let me know how the hell I work my television and the internet. Goodbye. Because after I do this vlog, won't be able to get on because Sharon's busy throwing up at my in-laws. Goodbye. Believe me, if I was at my in-laws, I'd be throwing up too. That's why I'm here. Dave's TV Empire.wordpress.com. Goodbye. Hope everyone doesn't see this. Goodbye.